Hi, I'm Bob Ward from the SQL Server engineering team. I'm here to show a brief demonstration of the automatic tuning feature, this time with Azure SQL Database Managed Instance. I've actually done a couple of other demonstrations and videos on our SQL Server YouTube channel with automatic tuning on SQL Server on Windows and SQL Server on Linux. And because Azure SQL Database Managed Instance has almost 100% compatibility with SQL Server on Windows or Linux, I am able to actually take a database backup from those environments and restore it directly to Azure SQL Database Managed Instance. That is one of the promises of compatibility of this new Azure service. You can see here in front of me, I've got a web page that gives you instructions about how to actually go about restoring your backup. And in this case, the Wide World Importer Standard Backup, which is what I'm going to actually use for my demonstration for automatic tuning, and has been the demonstration, the actual backup file I've been using for demos using automatic tuning. So here is SQL Server Management Studio and a script I wrote. I'm connected to an Azure Database Managed Instance, and I've copied, per the instructions on that web page, my Wide World Importer's backup file to an Azure Blob container, and I'm doing a restore from that container, and it succeeded. Now, looking at SQL Operations Studio, I've got the same set of scripts that I've used in the past on SQL Server on Linux to demonstrate automatic tuning. I can't use Windows Performance Monitor because that's a tool that's not going to work directly in an Azure Managed Instance environment. That's okay, because we can use the same set of scripts and repos that we've done for SQL Server on Linux for automatic tuning to show it for Azure Managed Instance. So if you've seen that video in the scripts, I've taken the Wide World Importer sample and modified it to add a stored procedure with an integer parameter that shows a query plan regression problem. Now, because I don't have Windows Performance Monitor, what I'm able to do is actually run a script that will collect perfmon SQL Server data, batch requests per second, into a global temporary table, and then I can run another query to iterate and look at those results and observe my workload. So let me actually run the initialize script, and I'll show you at the end of this video how you get these scripts in my GitHub repo. And I'll run this first to initialize my environment. And then I'm going to kick off my workload. This is this report procedure. And then I'll kick off my collector to collect data, batch requests per second, into this global temporary table. Now the batch request SQL script will be used to go observe what is the normal performance of my report workload over time. And if I click and I get a series of data over time, I'm using the new charting capabilities in SQL Operations Studio by looking at a counter, a time, and a value. And I can go over here and I can view this in a chart format. And if I look at time series, this right here represents kind of the standard workload throughput I have for this report procedure. Now I'm going to run this regression script, which is going to simulate a query plan regression problem. And if I go back and run my batch request again, I'm going to observe the regression problem that occurs with this workload. So I'll click a few times here to get some results. I'll go here and look at my time series, and you can see the performance degradation. Here was what my normal workload was looking like, and now I've got a degradation problem. Now by default, just like in SQL Server on Windows and Linux, if query store is enabled, I can go look at a recommendations DMV to find out what might be happening. And you can see here that the average CPU time has actually increased over time by 4 or 5 times worse than before, but the query plan is different with the same query. So if you look at the script column, I can use that to revert back to the previous plan. But let's see now what this looks like when you enable automatic tuning. So let me stop my workload. I'll stop my collector. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a script called autotune.sql, which is going to run a stored procedure, which will clear the query store, clear the procedure cache, and turn on automatic tuning. So I'm going to go back now, and I'm going to run my workload again. I'll kick off my collector. And we can observe, again, its performance over time, what a normal throughput looks like for this stored procedure. And if you click on the time series chart, you can get a feel, again, of what that looks like. So this is my workload. Let me run the regression again and go back and observe workload changes. You can even see by the numbers here that they've reduced because of the regression. But what you're going to find is because of the fact that automatic tuning is enabled, performance is going to go right back to where it was and even slightly a little faster. So let's see what that looks like in a chart. And you can see that here is the workload performance. It degraded. There was a small blip where it went up, but mostly it was in a degraded state with a query planned regression problem. And now performance has gone back up to the level where it was before. If I look at my recommendations, I can click here, and I can see the fact that we detected that there was a query plan regression problem where the average CPU time got worse, but notice that the state transition is last good plan force. This is very similar to the behavior on SQL Server on Windows and SQL Server on Linux. So what I've just demonstrated to you is the ability to restore a backup from SQL Server in a Windows or Linux environment, restore it directly to Azure SQL Database Managed Instance after putting it into a known Azure Blob container, and then running the same automatic tuning demonstration I've shown you in the past for a SQL Server on Windows or Linux. If you'd like to get the scripts for the demonstration that I just showed you, you can just use the scripts from the SQL Server Linux Auto-Tune demo that's available here on the Bob SQL GitHub repo. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration today. This is showing the power of automatic tuning of SQL Server, both on SQL Server Windows, Linux, and an Azure SQL Database Managed Instance. Thank you for your time.